Welcome back to the course introduction to Capella. In this next phase, we're going to talk about refining and defining the actors of the physical components and for this change that we're doing to introduce an operator. So what we're going to do in this phase is first we're going to focus on this capability of refining and defining the actors. We're going to focus on these steps that are involved here with this blue flow, which is refining and defining the physical components and actors. And so the first part of it is we're going to basically start with a transition. So we're going to start with transitioning the objects. So we're going to transition all the different elements that we needed from the logical architecture, and they're going to be transitioned over into the physical architecture. Now we have two ways we can do that. We can do that with the guide us process steps. But the preferred way is to actually use the explicit step of transitioning from logical. So I will go through the process to basically do that transition from logical. This is preferred when you're doing a change. And then once that's done, we're going to go through a whole number of steps. It's going to be done a little bit accelerated, but we're going to clone an existing diagram to repurpose for this new capability. We're going to introduce the operator in the base station that will receive the status information and the location information of the charger. We're going to introduce to the telemetry box a new control board that will support the microprocessor communications and GPS along with existing status information. And we're going to introduce a PC to gather the data from the base station and plot it to a map. So it's going to be a pretty aggressive step. I hope you enjoy watching the video on this. Thank you. So the first thing we're going to do here is we're going to do the transition from the logical content to the logical architecture. So we do that by going back to the logical architecture diagram and selecting objects that we want to do the transition. First, we transition the GPS object. Then we transition the actor for the operator. And then we're going to process the transition for all the functional chains, and that'll bring the functional chains across to the system. All the functional chains are now sent over. So that's the process of the transitioning. Once that's done, we can go back to the physical architecture. At the physical architecture now, we're basically going to go and clone a diagram. So we're going to clone a new diagram for this new operator change. And when we see this diagram, there's a lot of content here that we really don't need to use for this new operator. So we're going to look around and see what content we can remove from it, basically. And so I'm going to start here, but I did the clone operation, and now I'm going to basically rename it to something that will be just dealing with the operator. Okay, there's the new diagram. So now once this diagram's created, we can go in and start authoring it. Now I noticed before we could, there's a lot of content here that we can use, and there's content here that we don't need. So what I'm going to do is start selectively removing some of the content that I really don't need. Now by removing it, I'm just removing it from the diagram. You'll see that I'm using the single X button. The single X button only removes it from the diagram, doesn't remove it from the model. So I'm just taking it off, and I'm going to remove some content that I don't need, such as the battery holder. Don't really need to worry about the batteries in this sense. So I'm going to remove things and then reposition things that I want to keep. So I'm making room here so I can start doing my new components. I can put them on top of this of the trail power system here. Now I am going to keep the telemetry box. I talked about doing that before in the description of what we're going to modify. So the telemetry box is going to remain around. Okay, you can see here I've already made some changes. I made some quick changes, and you see that the telemetry box, and now I'm going to actually add in some actors. These are some of the actors that I had earlier. So I added added in, now I'm adding in the new operator for the base station. Adding in the antenna for the base station. Making some decisions. I'm going to add a photon particle in the base station for the processor capability for it, very similar to what I used previously in the telemetry box. Now in the telemetry box, I am introducing another processor. Adding in a GPS antenna into the telemetry box. GPS module. Decided to move some content that I didn't need. Again, to free up more space. So I decided to add a tracking card at this point that I'm going to put some of the content inside of. So I'm going to mount the Arduino 101 and the GPS receiver on this tracking card. Now I'm going and doing the, I just inserted an actor. I'm going to insert the operator actor. These were things that were transitioned over. And I'm connecting those up to what I've designed in the telemetry card. Now these are physical connections that I'm making here, as opposed to non-physical connections. The physical connections I'm labeling usually EL for electrical, and RF for radio frequency. I'll use HMI for human interfaces. So these are actually things that either you'll touch or they're actually the way that the operator may invoke operations. And I'm cleaning up and removing some content that I don't need from the diagram, related to other aspects of the system. And now I'm adding in a move charger function to an actor called the user. And this is part of the request that I want to be able to detect whether the system is being moved. So the concept here is I'm going to use the IMU that's inside of the Arduino 101, which is an inertial measurement unit, to basically detect the acceleration of the object being moved. This will be handy because it'll help reduce the amount of power. I won't actually go and request GPS information unless the system is being moved. So that way I'm not always running the GPS, and it should save power by doing it this approach. Now I'm adding in the Wi-Fi capability, and I'm going to be moving adding in capability for the transmission of radio receivers. So I'm deciding that I'm going to use some LoRa communications, which we talked about in logical architecture. That's going to be used to communicate the 2 mile range that we need to do. It's a good component for doing that. And I'm going to put that in here. So I've got antennas and I've got the receivers, and I'm going to connect those up between the Arduino 101 to the photon particle. Notice those are electrical connections, so I'm using EL for electrical. Making all these physical links. And then what I'm going to do is these things are fairly simple devices, so I really don't need to go detail out behaviors or functionality for them. So what I'm going to do is just group them together as a physical path that basically will be just treated essentially as like one object that the functions will basically flow over. And let me get them neatened up a little bit here. You'll see me create the physical path that goes between them. The physical path is a great way to simplify your diagrams and not have to add a lot of functionality. So there's the physical path object, and I'm basically calling that the LoRa physical path. And again, I have there in the notes there that it is a simplified, it's a way to simplify it. And if you know the functionality of something and it's so obvious, you don't really need to go and detail out the behaviors and the functionality of it. I did similar things before with the Wi-Fi and the internet connection. It wasn't necessary to go in and detail the behaviors of those. Now I'm basically introducing a device that the operator will receive the data on. In this point, I'm just saying a PC, but it could also be an iPad, and then there'll be eventually software on it that runs it. So it ends up having that I end up having my display. I'm introducing a little bit of a cloud component here, which I had a cloud for the ThingSpeak cloud, but in this case, I'm going to use the particle cloud, which is a part of that particle photon that allows you to send information to other devices and access that information from other devices. And it does have capabilities for doing GPS tracking. Cleaning the diagrams up a little bit more, I took a few more things off. I'm going to reorganize them a bit. One thing I started thinking about after I had gotten this far and actually had gotten a little bit into this is that I actually created a new tracking control card. It's possible that I could reuse the telemetry card. So I will go ahead and make a change here in a moment where I'm going to reuse the telemetry card that was used in the previous section. I'm going to basically do that. So here I'm creating a physical path for the communications. And I'm modifying that physical path a little bit to make it a little more detailed. So you can actually have a physical path diagram that you can create and to make modifications to the physical path. It's a little more complicated than selecting the objects and say create physical path. There, I've done that. And at this point in time, I'm going to go in and adding a few more links for the operator to the PC. That's going to be an HMI, human machine interface. So it's going to basically be the user can see it and interact with it. And now I'm going on to deciding that I want to change the board. I want to use the existing telemetry board, which I already had, and I'm going to use that for the control tracking board. The reason why I want to do that is that I do have the need for some status information. So a status might be the charge of the battery, and that this telemetry board already is collecting the charge for the battery. So it'd be better to modify it and just add the capability of connecting into this new processor, the Arduino 101, the information that was already collected on the other boards so that I could add that. So it's going to be a nice way of doing that. And I can continue to use the same telemetry board that I have, or I could choose to even get rid of the particle photon that was on the original. I could depopulate it on that board. What you're seeing here is I attempted to delete the object, and I noticed that I had some relationships connected to it. And this was going to be a full delete. And the reason why is the way those relationships are actually owned by the tracking control card as a sub object. So what I'm doing here is I basically went in and I exposed, I unfiltered some content, and now I'm going to move the links that were part of the tracking control card. I'm going to move them to the telemetry PCB, so that way I don't have to redraw the diagram, redraw those lines. They'll just move to the right place. So I did that, and we've got things all kind of cleaned up. And that pretty much ends this session. Thank you very much.